Welcome to Manipati. In this video, I will discuss about TCS, which is also known as Tata Consultancy Services. It is crown jewel of Tata Group, like the major revenue generator and profit generator for the group. TCS is the largest IT company of India, and it is one of the largest IT company in the world as well. So TCS is a giant when it comes to IT services. The company has two business operations, product and services. So if you are from IT background, you can easily distinguish between product and services. For users who are not from IT background, let me set some example. For example, if you are using SBI online banking, and if TCS has given their package for online banking, it is called a product. Services is the TCS will maintain website of SBI. So if there is any problem with the website of SBI, SBI will tell TCS that this is problem I am having, so TCS will have to fix it. So this is kind of services. They will develop new features into the websites as well. So product and services are two major revenue generator for the Tata Group, Tata TCS, services being the dominant one. I gave example of SBI. TCS does have clients all over the world for the services part. The products part, it has created over the years with experience on the services. Different products are Chroma, Ignio, Zile, TCS Optumera, Quartz Blockchain, TAP, TCS Banks, TCS Ion, TCS Mastercraft. Most of the services belong to a cater to the cloud ones, blockchains, IoT, because those are the future where all the IT services players see major revenue growth and growth potential. On the product part, let me cite you example. Suppose for banking, online banking, if you have seen different online banking, the interface is different, but the features you get are same. So banks, TCS Banks is an online banking platform. So TCS may sell bank to SBI, and SBI may say that you need to change few things in your bank's package. So TCS will change those things for SBI. And similarly for HDFC Bank, it may opt for different changes. So what TCS gets benefited is it sells its own product, and it also customizes and provides services and support to the products it sold. So with one product selling, it gets services as well. So the second revenue generator is support and services division. Just a clarity, TCS not only provides services and support for its product, but it also provides services and support for different applications and different products. Like our bank may have Finacle installed for it. Finacle is an Infosys software package for banks. So TCS may also provide services for that as well. So this is a kind of services is a kind of providing intellectual solutions for your business problems. So it's a major revenue stream for TCS. TCS is present in all over the world. It has presence in North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Asia, as well as Australia. So the revenue is not dependent on one geography. Over the years, the Indian IT companies have tried to lessen their dependency from US and venture into the new destinations like Europe and South America, Australia. So this has paid off, and the dependency on the US have become less. TCS does have Indian clients as well. So that's another revenue stream for the company. So it, as of now, it has 4 lakh employees as well. So IT, just to give you a glimpse of IT industry as a whole, is a stable, mature industry. So Indian IT industry has matured and is stable, and with time it will have a slow growth as well, because IT will keep evolving. With every change, the system changes, new features are added on the system. For example, PM started like Samriddhi Yojana, okay, PM Awas Yojana or any Yojanas. So that option should be available on the internet banking. So banks will have to modify it. Now who will modify it? The IT services company will modify it, either TCS or Infosys will modify it. So the people who said in 2007 and before that IT services is dead are wrong. IT is here to stay and it will keep evolving. The technology will change, so does the companies will evolve. For your information, in the video description you will find link to my website, where you will find details of all listed Tata Group of company. Along with that, you will also find details of all listed companies from different corporate groups like HDFC, Bajaj, Mahindra, etc. I will also create separate videos on those companies and corporate groups. To get notified about those videos, you need to subscribe to my Manipati YouTube channel. The subscription is very easy. Below the video, you will see subscribe button. You need to click on the subscribe button. Once you click on the subscribe button, you will see bell icon. You need to click on bell icon. This way, whenever I will post a video, you will get notified and you can watch the video. Just a disclaimer, I am not a SEBI registered analyst. The views expressed in this video and on my website are for my own research, and I make it public so that someone might find it useful. Thank you.